Yo, what's everybody? How's everyone doing? As you can tell by the title, we are going to be reviewing probably the best budget 60% mechanical keyboard on the market right now. There is a couple more on the market as well, especially on Amazon and Banga.com, but I found this one to be the best budget mechanical keyboard for the price, and the features are just so much better than the other budget ones out there, and they're very close to like an Ampro 2 or like a Ducky or like a GMMK. So yeah, today we're going to be reviewing the GK61, as you can tell by the title. And yeah, hope you guys enjoy the video. Make sure to follow my Twitch if you want to see this keyboard more in action, especially on Monday. I'm going to be doing a building stream. I ordered some new keycaps. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to subscribe, and yeah. Alright, so first we're going to talk about the build quality of this keyboard. So as you can see, it's mostly plastic around the shell, on the bottom as well. We do have four rubber feet on each corner. This keyboard does not have the adjustable feet because of the kind of OEM layout. It's kind of raised. I don't know if you guys can see that. It's a little bit raised, so it's kind of like perfect for typing and gaming. You don't really need it to be raised more or lowered more or anything. So it's at a perfect height, and the keycaps are ABS plastic, but they are double shot. So basically, if you don't know what ABS plastic is, it's basically a cheap, not cheap, but like a cheaper version of the other type of plastic, which is called PBT. ABS plastic tends to like wear, the keycaps tend to wear after a while. Also, they can show a little bit of sweat residue on there. And yeah, they're just not as good quality as PBT keycaps, but a lot of big name companies like Razer and stuff, they use ABS plastic as well. So yeah, it's kind of rare to see PBT keycaps come with stock keyboards. But yeah, the build quality is really good. There's no really any flex. As you can see, I'm like trying to twist it. There's no flex at all. No creaking, no nothing, nothing like that. Keycaps sound, keycaps feel still good as well. We're gonna go on to the switches on this keyboard now. I recently did a stream where I actually switched my my switches. I ordered this keyboard with brown switches, which I don't have them on right now, but I put on new silver switches that I ordered, and the options that come with this keyboard are, first of all, they're Gateron switches. So basically, they come with either blacks, browns, reds, or blues, and they're Gateron only. And this keyboard also is an optical keyboard, and it's hot swappable. So that means you can hot swap the switches out, which I have done, but you have to use optical switches. And also in the box, which is right here, this is the box that it comes in. As you can tell, focus. They do come with brown switches, which I have ordered, and the keyboard is RGB, as you can tell as well. And there's also a white version. I chose the black one. But yeah, the stuff that you get in the box, what you will get in the box is obviously the keyboard, the USB Type-C cable, which is another great feature to this keyboard. Also, this USB Type-C, you can plug it in either way. It doesn't matter which way it goes. And it has this cool little effect when you turn on. And also, you get in the box a switch puller to hot swap your switches out, and a keycap puller. Obviously, these kind of switch pullers and keycap pullers are not really the best. They're just, you know, it's kind of standard. But they work, man. I use them to take out my keycaps and my switches, and yeah, it works pretty fine. So I can show you guys the switches now. We'll just take out the escape key. I'm just gonna turn the lighting off. As you can tell, I have silver switches. I do have the brown switches that I can show you that came with my keyboard. So I got the brown switches in the bag that I got my silver switches in. And here are the Gateron browns that do come with this keyboard. So yeah, those are the brown switches that I got with my keyboard. The brown switches feel really nice. I probably should have done a sound test before I did before I switched to the silver switches, but the brown switches feel really nice. They're really smooth. They sound really good. But for me, I just wanted to try these silver switches out, as you can see. Yeah, I just wanted to try them out because I never tried a linear switch before. And yeah, I don't know. I just really wanted to try silver switches, so that's what I did. And if you guys also order this keyboard and you want to switch out the switches, I will leave a link to a website down below where you can get the optical switches from. They're actually from the company that makes this keyboard. So yeah, the keycaps also have this like glossy kind of finish on the edges, like the sides of the keycaps. So on the top, they obviously have that normal finish. So yeah, it kind of makes the keyboard look kind of glossy all around. It also has it on this part here and this part here, right down here. All right, so we're gonna move on to the lighting effects, the different lighting effects you have in this keyboard. There is and also a software that you can download, a driver software for this keyboard, where you can do a little bit more. All right, so obviously when you click function and then the backspace key, you can turn it on and off. And then if you click function and then this button right here, you can cycle through the different modes. So this one kind of like circles around like that. This one kind of goes from the bottom up to different colors. You can tell like that. If you do it again, you can change what static color you want in the software to be on the keyboard. This one we're going to have like just a pulsing of a bunch of colors. And then we're back to the regular RGB swipe going in a certain direction. And then if we click function and then this key right here, which is beside the other key, you can cycle through the different lighting effects when you click a certain key. So if I do this, it'll kind of illuminate the key for a second. And you can also, with all of these effects, you can also change the speed and brightness. If you click function and then either this one's for brightness going up and this one's turning the brightness down. So if I do that, the brightness will go up. If I do this one, that it will change the speed. If I do this one here, it will lower the speed, so it'll stay for longer. And if I put it to the max, it'll just be quick, just like that. And if I click function and this key again, it will change the mode, so it'll kind of do this swipe across the whole keyboard when you click a certain row, like that. And if I do it again, it'll kind of make this like pulse thing. It's actually really cool. So if you go from the escape key, it just goes across the whole keyboard or like that. I like this mode a lot. Actually, it's really cool. And then if you do it again, there also, if I actually take this space bar off, there is a microphone, a little tiny, tiny microphone, which you can see right there. Basically, they're not trying to spy on you or anything. But basically what it does is whenever you talk, la 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 la, it's kind of like an equalizer. So if I don't talk, doesn't really make a noise. And when I start talking, it kind of like, yeah, it's kind of like an equalizer on your keyboard. So it's really cool. And if you click it again, you just go back to the standard mode like this. So I'm just going to leave it on this mode right here. Hopefully it focuses. There we go. So yeah, the font on this, on the, standard keycaps as well are very nice. They're not too gamery. They're actually very similar to the Ampro 2, as you can tell. It really lets the RGB light shine through, and it's not too thick, not too thin, not too gamery looking. I love it, nice and clean. And yeah, this keyboard also has some profiles, so you can set certain profiles. This is one of the effects from the software. There's one like onboard profile, and then there's profiles from your computer. So yeah, you can change like per key lighting on here as well. There's different modes. So there's three actual different profiles you can choose from, and then the one from your computer, which is on Q. And as you can tell, since this is a 60% keyboard, it does not have dedicated arrow keys. So basically what you have to do is you gotta hold function, and then there's arrow keys right down here, and then click which one you want while you're holding function to use the arrow keys. And then when you don't want to use them, you can just use the regular keys that are there. And yeah, we'll just do a quick sound test on 10fastfingers.com, and we'll, yeah, see how the silver switches sound for you guys. All right, these are the silver switches on the GK61 sound test. Dude, who's calling me? Oh my god. Okay, so that was the sound of the GK61 silver switches. I'm sorry I couldn't actually give you guys the sound of the brown switches. But yeah, the silver switches sound really good and the brown switches sound really good. They're both really smooth. Nice and smooth Gateron switches. Gateron switches have always been a lot smoother than cherry switches, people say, and I kind of feel that too. So yeah, I do recommend going with this keyboard. So now we are looking at the GK61 software. Now it is a little bit confusing. It's not really the best software, I'm gonna be honest. So basically, if you want to change, like, if you want to make it a solid color, so you basically pick a color from here. I'm just gonna go with this blue, or I think it's blue or purple, and you basically just like highlight what keys you want to make it, what you want to make that color. So let's say I want the whole keyboard like that. I just go across like that, I click use and then apply, and then basically you have this purple. I don't know if it really looks like purple on camera, but it looks like purple to me on the keyboard. And then let's say I want to go for red on like one half of the keyboard. Just go like that, click use and apply, and then basically it'll just do that. And then you can change it to any key. You can let's say I just want to do this color here, make it, I might want to make the J that color. There you go. Let's say I want to do yellow for like the WASD or something. Just click use, apply, and then there you go. WASD is yellow now. And there is a bunch of lighting effects here as well you can go through. Some of them are already on the keyboard. Some of them there's like only on the software things. Yeah, there's a bunch here. Some presets that are on the software. I thought you could maybe download some like online that people have made, but I couldn't really find that out. So yeah, you can also do macros here, which I'm not really sure how to use. I'm going to be honest, I got to do some more research into that. But I'm sure if you search up a YouTube video or something, or just Google it, you can probably find out how to do it. Because it's mostly in Chinese, which I don't know why. But yeah, that's basically it for the software. Not too much to it. It's a little bit complicated, but once you get used to changing the lighting effects, it should be pretty self-explanatory. And yeah, let's just get on to the games with this keyboard.
use code SaySideways15 to iDrop. Oh yeah, if you don't use it, you will not get a cookie. Make sure you use code SaySideways15 in the item shop. Oh yeah.
Alright guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed that video on me reviewing the 60% GK61 with silver switches. Would I recommend this keyboard? Absolutely 100%. It's probably the best budget 60% keyboard that you can get if you don't have the money for like a Ducky or like an M-Pro 2. Definitely get it over like the RK61, the Moto Speed, those like budget keyboards. They're not really too good. I think this is the best budget keyboard, best budget 60% keyboard for the price. In Canadian price, I think I paid around like $60. I'm pretty sure Americans like $45 or $50, so it's a really good deal. And yeah, you can get it on Amazon, Bango.com, eBay, stuff like that. So I'll leave links in the description if you want to go check it out and buy it for yourself. But yeah guys, that's gonna be it for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to follow my Twitch if you want to see this keyboard in action and me putting my new keycaps on Monday. I will be streaming that. Make sure to subscribe to the channel, turn those post notifications on, and don't forget to like the video. Peace out guys.